Simon & Schuster Audio presents The Modern Guide to Witchcraft, Your Complete Guide to Witches, Covens, and Spells by Skye Alexander. Read by Wendy Tremont King. Introduction. So you want to be a witch. You've picked up this book because you're interested in witches. You wonder about who they are and what they believe. You know being a witch has something to do with finding a deeper connection to nature and to the entire cosmos. With finding an inner power and beauty that can help you accomplish what you want in life. In the back of your mind flits the image of an ugly old woman dressed in black, riding a broomstick. But you know that's wrong, and you want to find out more. What does it mean to be a witch? Witches come in all sizes, ages, colors, and personalities. They're doctors, computer programmers, teachers, landscapers, bartenders, and flight attendants. The person who cuts your hair or repairs your car might be a witch. Witches can be male or female. No, a male witch is not a warlock. And he might get angry if you call him that, for good reason. Warlock comes from an old English word meaning oath breaker or liar. The simple fact that you're reading this book suggests that you think you too have witch potential. Guess what? You do. And with a little training, you can uncover your magical power and learn to use it to shape your destiny. Why is witchcraft gaining popularity today? Witchcraft resonates with us because it speaks to some key issues of today: respect for the environment, gender equality, and overcoming religious biases and narrow-minded thinking. It also encourages those who follow this path to discover and develop their own unique powers so they can take charge of their lives and be everything they choose to be. In general, most witches seek to improve themselves and humankind as a whole, and to live in harmony with the universe. This means working for the greater good, often through the use of magic, and harming none. It also means taking responsibility for your thoughts, words, and deeds, because everything you do affects everything else. Once you learn to harness your natural talents as a witch, you'll discover that a whole new world of possibilities exists. You'll be able to use what's known as the law of attraction to improve your financial situation, your relationships, your health, and your overall well-being. You'll also have the power to help others, and you'll gain a greater sense of your place in the universe. Magic won't help you finish a project for school or work, or make you taller, or fix a flat tire. However, it can strengthen your concentration and mental receptivity, make you more attractive to other people, or draw someone to you who can repair that flat. It's a good idea to take it slow in the beginning, just as you would if you were training for a marathon. That way, you'll have fun and avoid setbacks. What you'll learn from this book. We're all born magical beings. As children, we know this, but as we grow up, we forget our true nature. We listen to other people whose limited views cause us to doubt our innate powers, and we get caught up in the stresses of everyday life. This book shows you how to reconnect with the magic in you. As you read these pages, you'll learn to pay attention to your intuition and let it guide you. You'll gain a greater appreciation and awareness of the natural world, the cycles of the moon, the energies of the seasons, your links with the animals, birds, and other creatures who share this planet with you. You'll also discover how to incorporate nature's tools, herbs and flowers, crystals and gemstones, and more, into your magical workings. You'll come to realize that witchcraft and magic aren't hocus pocus. They are your birthright. They already exist deep within you. You already have the power to tap into the energies of the natural world and the cosmos. You just need to recognize that power and learn to direct it. That's what this book is about, reconnecting with your magical self. True magic lies in developing your inner potential and spirituality. This book is intended to help you on that journey toward getting in touch with nature, with the divine, and with your own innate abilities. Because ultimately, that's the real source of witchcraft. Part 1. Welcome to the Wonderful World of Witchcraft. Chapter 1. What is witchcraft? Snow White, Cinderella, The Wizard of Oz, Alice in Wonderland, Beauty and the Beast, Peter Pan, Star Wars. Most of us first discovered wizards and witches, spells and potions, and the never-ending struggle between good and evil through these stories. Fairy tales showed us a world filled with magic, one where inanimate objects like mirrors, stones, and gems can have special powers. Animals can talk, plants can think, and with a sprinkling of dust, kids can fly. Then we grew up and forgot about magic. Our lives became a little less rich, and our imaginations started to shrivel as we got mired in the mundane details of our daily lives. But every now and then, we recapture some of that early magic through books and movies like E.T., Lord of the Rings, and Harry Potter. We find ourselves fascinated once again by the supernatural world and eager to reawaken the magic within us. Common misconceptions about witches. Before we go any further, let's get rid of those ridiculous ideas some people still hold about witches. Misconceptions about witches come from ignorance and fear. For centuries, mainstream religions have encouraged negative images about witches, and during a period known as the Burning Times, these false ideas led to the deaths of countless innocent people in Europe and the New World. In recent times, the media continue to present a distorted picture of witches and magic, further confusing the issue. For the record, witches do not steal or eat babies. This idea comes from old folklore, and fairies were often blamed for doing the same thing. Witches are not Satanists who sell their souls to the devil in return for special powers. Lots of witches don't even believe in Satan. He's a Christian conception. Witches don't ride brooms. They get around in cars, trains, and airplanes just like everyone else. You might see a bumper sticker that says, "I'm driving this car because my broom's in the shop," but that's just a joke. Witches prefer pizza over Eye of the Newt any day. Witches don't inherit magical powers from mysterious ancestors, although if Grandma was a witch and trained you in the craft from childhood, you'll have a head start on other wannabe witches. Not all witches possess remarkable psychic powers, nor do they have the gift of prophecy. Some psychics may be witches, and many witches develop their intuition through practice. But the truth is, everyone has psychic ability, including you. Witches don't consort with or battle demons, vampires, zombies, or other monsters. They have better things to do. Not all witches worship ancient gods and goddesses. Some don't believe in any type of deity. Witches aren't immortal. They live ordinary lifespans just like other humans. Witches aren't ugly old hags. They can be young and incredibly beautiful. But most of them are just average people like you and me. Witches don't engage in rivalries and conflicts with other magical practitioners. The witches in Salem, Massachusetts, for example, don't have a long-standing rivalry with New Orleans voodoo priestesses. Trust me on this. I've been a witch for 25 years and lived in Salem for 8. And I get along with people from New Orleans just fine. If you choose to become a witch, you'll have to throw out all the silly...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.